When I say I found the best budget laptop on the planet, I mean the best laptop from the perspective of the planet, since this laptop does not immediately become obsolete the second after you buy it. Historically, nearly every laptop manufactured since the Younger Dryas has been unmodular and unupgradable computational slabs of circuitry. However, this brand new laptop called the Framework 12 is the only laptop that I've ever seen that ships like this. Obviously, you can buy it fully assembled, of course, but where's the fun in that? The Framework DIY kit is where it's at, where every single component is backwardly and forwardly compatible with the future. You can think of Framework as the Fairphone of computers, and it starts at $559 if you assemble it yourself, and that's a pretty wild price. From the motherboard, to the memory, to the battery, every screw is labeled, and every component has a QR code which corresponds with a tutorial on how to swap it out, if you're into instructions, that is. Now, I imagine I'm supposed to just slap in some RAM and an SSD at this point, but I'd rather delve a bit deeper into the Framework 12 first, before turning it on for the first time. The DIY kit knocks a few hundred bucks off the cost of the laptop when you finish assembling it yourself, and I'm just assuming since we need a keyboard, it's probably in this box. There are also hot swappable, customizable modular ports that we'll get to in a second. And of course, a standard M.2 SSD and equally standard sized non-solder DDR5 RAM. Framework is the antithesis of Apple. Say no more. There's even a color-matched Framework screwdriver that works with every screw in the laptop, and I'm sure Framework isn't gonna mind if we tear it down all the way first before building it the rest of the way up. Instantly though, I see that this Framework 12 laptop is almost too repairable. Normally, I'll always have a few screws left over after every repair, I kinda collect them, and it's a rite of passage. But Framework has taken that away from me by making every screw captive, meaning it can unscrew, right, but stays attached to whatever module it's holding in. And new modules, like this 50 watt hour battery, will come with screws already in position. I like how it says this battery is replaceable, because Apple would never. With the battery removed, we can see the core of the laptop is made from metal, then a colored plastic, and an overmolded rubbery layer, just like a built-in protective case. The lighter colored rubber is surrounding the edges of the outside, so it does appear more durable. If we get 50,000 likes, I'll throw it off my roof. There's a bunch of magnets around the inside, and I assume this is to help the lid stay closed when we put it all back together. The dual loudspeakers are modular, each of these are 2 watts, and again both have the same style of captive screws, so there's nothing to keep organized. Both speakers are connected to the same audio board, which also contains our headphone jack, thumbs up for that. You'll see these springy pogo pins in a few places around the Framework 12. Instead of Lego style or ribbon connectors, Framework is using these little springy boys to maintain contact with a pad on the opposite board. Unless, of course, the laptop gets wet and the contact points oxidize, but you'll probably have other, more bigger problems at that point anyway. The dual speakers are wired to the same pogo connectors and have their captive screws still in place, but I'm not immediately seeing any balls inside. Not gonna lie though, this whole not needing to keep track of my screws thing is pretty awesome. If Framework were to make a phone, I would be so happy. Let's not get distracted though. I just noticed that everyone on the Framework team gets their names printed inside the laptop. I'm liking these guys more and more. The power button board has another captive screw, and some more pogo pin pads. There are 5 more screws marked by orange that hold in the main board. And fun fact about pogos, as a kid I wanted to break the world record for pogo stick jumps. I got to a personal best of about 1,000 jumps before realizing that the record was over 100,000. Maybe one of these days I'll have to pick it back up again. If I lift up on the 2 orange pull tabs, the 2 Lego style connections can come loose from the board. The screen probably has too much data transferring for pogo pins to handle, but at least these pull tabs make it super simple for someone who's never replaced a motherboard before to replace a motherboard. The little Wi-Fi card has 2 signal wires attached to it as well. Again, this is deeper than most people will ever need to go inside of the Framework 12, but it's still cool to poke around in here. The turbo fan looks rather glorious, and I don't know what any of these circuits do on the back, but it looks like a little city for ants. It's nice of Framework to put their address and customer service phone number back here, probably because if you're in this deep, you took a wrong turn and definitely need directions. But in honor of Father's Day last week, I don't need no directions and I'm just gonna keep on going. To be fair though, Framework has done a really good job of making their semi-annual motherboard and processor upgrades backwards compatible for the past 4 years, and that's a pretty big deal. There's a magnetical flap that covers the RAM slot, and 4 screws that hold down the heat pipe, with three additional screws holding down the turbo fan, which then cools down the heat pipe. This is very similar to what we see inside most other laptops and the Red Magic gaming phones. It's interesting that even the copper plate that makes up the heatsink has its screw holes numbered in the order you're supposed to tighten the screws down in. Framework has thought of everything. My processor under the blacked out cooling system is the 13th generation Intel Core i3, which fits the less expensive vibe of the Framework 12. It does have an integrated GPU, so there's no heavy gaming on the Framework 12, but Framework does have a larger, more premium Framework 16 laptop, which apparently has a whole removable dedicated graphics card. So if you want to spend a bit more money and do some heavy gaming or video editing on a bigger screen, the 16's probably a better option. With the battery so easily plopped back in, I feel like I'm cheating, and it's time to throw in the SSD. The M.2 is a single terabyte, and I think we can put 2 terabytes into the same space if we wanted. I also have 16 gigs of DDR5, but I could bump it up to 48 using the same form factor. If you're not familiar with the words I'm using, like modular, repairable, and inexpensive, that's okay. At least your texts are blue. Finally, for the keyboard, what's really cool about this is that it also has no plugs. Just a heck of a lot of these pogo pads on the back, which line up with the pogo pins on the motherboard. The keyboard buttons have some decent depth to them, but I'm pretty unopinionated when it comes to keyboards. The keyboard does have threaded inserts on the back, which correspond to some more captive screws that you'll see in a second. I'll just plop the lower end of the keyboard into the frame of the Framework 12 and press it in, then flip it over to tighten the 8 captive screws waiting for me on the back side of the laptop. If for whatever reason one of these screws comes loose, there are 6 spare screws just screwed into the frame inside of the laptop. At this point, I can also choose which ports I want to include in the sides. Each of these modules range from a reasonable $11, like the USB-C port, all the way up to the most expensive, still reasonable, $25 SD card slot. And everything in between, from Ethernet to HDMI, USB-A, microSD, and even DisplayPort cards. I can get new cards and swap out old cards at any point and any time. Turning the computer on for the first time, I did have to install Windows myself since this is the DIY kit, but the pre-built laptops come with Windows already installed. And a neat party trick is that this Framework 12 has a 360-degree hinge, so you can use it in tablet mode. And I know this video sounds a bit like a sales pitch, but it's not sponsored. Framework just makes machines that are kinda everything I've been looking for in a laptop. Knowing that my laptop isn't gonna be obsolete right after I buy it is kinda nice. And you might be like, hey Jerry, what about the screen though? Is that part easy to replace? And yes it is. With the bottom plastics removed, we see another 4 non-captive screws. These ones are indeed totally losable, but the screen will probably be just fine if we only put back 2 or 3, so don't worry too much about it. Framework does have to go make it easy again by labeling the screw holes as an M2x2.8. So if you do lose any, now you know what size it is. I'll take the 12.2-inch LCD with its 60Hz refresh rate and 1920x1200 resolution and slide it down. There's no adhesive, and if the computer was turned off, I could just pop off these 2 ribbon cables and replace the whole screen in about 3 minutes. Funny enough, the replacement parts are already available on Framework's website. So if you happen to break your computer screen on day 1, the replacement pieces only cost $149. I'm a huge fan of what Framework is doing. Knowing that I could get a replacement screen in a pinch and not lose everything I'm working on would be some pretty nice peace of mind. Let me know if you want me to take a look at the more premium Framework 16 down in the comments. As a side note, since only awesome people make it to the end of my videos, every year my wheelchair factory releases a new collector's coin as a fundraiser, where 100% of the money we make goes towards making wheelchairs cheaper for those who need them. So if you have an extra $15 burning a hole in your pocket and want to help keep the lights on at my wheelchair factory, buying a coin would be very much appreciated. The silver coin is $15 and the gold is $100, but seriously, even just watching and sharing my videos is plenty of help already. So thanks a ton for watching. I'll see you around.